This show is part of the RetroZap.com podcast network.
Hi, this is Jonas Suotamo. I play Chewbacca in the Star Wars, and you're listening to Brews and Blasters.
Here we go.
You're listening to Brews and Blasters. The Star Wars party starts now.
How are we doing?
Same as always.
That bad, huh?
Pokey religions and ancient weapons are no match for a good blaster at your side, kid.
Let us go inside where we can discuss business over a drink.
Could you join us for a little refreshment?
Everyone's invited, of course.
With Chris Dalton and Joe Tavano, two guys from Boston, who are talking about this stuff anyway.
Whoa.
Let him marinate. It was like a good steak tip.
Oh, yeah.
And Renegades. They're having a nice time.
We just got a cup of super cold zippy sip.
Yes. We had a barbecue.
Society.
Okay, Star Wars.
With that guy.
Dangerous.
Welcome back to Brews and Blasters. This is the Star Wars Party Podcast, the only Star Wars podcast in the universe, the best Star Wars podcast in the universe.
That's a fact.
My name is Joe Tavano, and joining me, as always, my co-host, my brother, father-to-be, Chris Dalton.
Bingo bango, here I am. Hello.
Boom.
Hi.
Hello. Hi.
Hello.
Wow. Totally different energy, but I'm liking it.
Yeah.
I'm liking it.
I'm here.
How are you feeling?
I'm doing a lot better now. Yeah.
Yeah. Yeah. You weren't feeling good, but you know, before we talk about it, Chris, I need to know when.
Right.
When the Star Wars party begins. Kick it off for me, buddy. When does it begin?
Right. About now. See what I did there?
I did. I saw that. Yeah. How are you feeling?
I'm feeling a lot better.
Yeah. If you were checking the Twitter around Friday, around 8:30, we got some bad news.
Yeah.
Yeah. Well, actually, we got that news Wednesday, but we broke the news on Friday.
Yeah. Yeah.
Well, Chris got sicky sick.
Yeah. Thank you. Everyone for like the, you know, the feel better soon.
The well wishes.
Yeah. Thanks, guys.
Our listeners are great because,
yeah.
they all.
You care. I wasn't expecting that.
They all cared. Everyone said get well. But, you know, they also did some real funny stuff,
too. I really like the Raddus one.
The raddest one.
We rest.
That was that was Blast Point's podcast. I gotta say, some of the best guys out there. We just said we are the only and the best, but they're also the only and the best Sours podcast too. They are also, and everyone else too that we like. But yeah, we had a good time going through all of the well wishes. Someone just put a gif of Team America World Police.
Yeah, you know, yeah.
One of the papas just vomiting everywhere, and I was like, "What's going on?"
Yeah,
like this ain't gonna make him feel better at all.
That's definitely up there with the weirdest movies of all time.
I love that movie though.
It's so weird.
America.
Yeah,
it really is though. But it's just good. It's just good. You know what are you gonna say?
Yeah, right. Yeah, I mean. Know? But I'm feeling a lot better. Thank you for putting that out there. Great choice with the picture of Anakin burnt to all holy hell there.
He just looks miserable. And yeah. You know something? If you've ever been food poisoned and you didn't feel good, that's how you feel.
Yeah, you know, I did. Just, yeah. I mean, picture me with
that. That's it right there. That's how you look. That's exactly how you feel.
It really was. Yeah. I think I was laying like that at one point.
Probably,
you know?
Right? The metal hand.
Yep. Screaming, I hate you.
Who are you screaming that at?
To Pete's Roast Beef.
Yeah.
Never again. Don't care if you're listening.
Pete's,
sorry.
Pete's Super not Beef really. On North Shore Road, Revere. Yeah. Is that what you're talking about?
Yeah. Don't care. Not sorry. Bye.
Yeah. You got that romaine lettuce, huh?
Yeah, I must have got something.
Yeah, you must have.
You would think you would be safe with the chicken kebab.
You went healthy with the salad. Yeah,
I went healthy, got sick. I should have got the extra greasy, you know, like roast beef.
Oh yeah, definitely.
Or pastrami.
I love listener Melanie here. She sent one from looks like Parks and Rec.
Yeah.
Saying the calzones, the calzones betrayed me.
It was funny because you took immediate offense to the calzone. You're like, not if you get a good one.
Real calzones, would never do such a thing.
Yeah, don't say that about food, will you?
Yeah. Seriously, a real calzone would never make you sick. Yeah. For real.
That's why I was looking. I was like, wow, there's a lot of people that care.
Yeah. Yeah, we got a good little
nice little community.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah. The Brews and Blasters community is the best community out there.
Yeah.
I have to say. Everyone who listens to the show, just top notch people. Seriously, I love hearing from everyone who listens to the show. I mean, they're unbelievable. They have such good hearted nature about them. And we live in a time in the world where not everyone's nice and social media is just getting worse and worse by the day. And I just love going to the Brews and Blasters account and seeing how many awesome people are there and just having a good time.
It's true, because when you put that out, I was like, no one's going to care. Yeah. And then I was like, at that point, it was like 11 response.
Yeah.
Hey, guys, that's a lot for us, okay?
It's a big deal.
Yeah, I like that. Over 10. Yeah, okay.
Look at that. Double digits.
We did it.
We did it.
No, you guys did it, actually.
You did.
We show up and you guys show up and I don't know what we do.
We just got sick. That's all we did.
Yeah, we got sick. Yeah. Yeah, I had a pretty eventful last couple of weeks, I would say.
Exactly. We have more. We'll talk about that, too. We went to a baby expo.
Yeah, we did.
Yeah, different kind of con, guys.
Yeah, hey, it was weird because when I was there... Now, Alexa enjoys herself. She does.
Yeah, we you know, some people were going to Awesome Con the past couple of weeks. Going to some convention. We were going to Baby Con. Yeah.
But I was thinking, like, right when I got in, I was like, wow, this is like all the conventions I've dragged her to.
Mm-hmm.
But it's like baby stuff, you know?
Mm-hmm.
So we did that. I mean, a lot of cool stuff. There's like new things getting made every day. And I like how the things
the
are
tech.
Just making life easy.
I'm
all about that.
I'm all about making the life easier, new technology, thinking about, you know.
Technology.
Lead us to kings.
Yeah, there was a carriage. Like, you came in. I'm like, dude, this carriage that folds into.
It's an egg.
It was a cube. Yeah, it was a transformer.
It really did. You made the noise. It goes. Yeah. And it's like, yeah, that's it.
I almost bought it, but then there was like hidden charges.
Yeah,
she was like,
"Yeah,
that one's 220." I'm like, "Wrap it up." She's like, "And then you get it, you get this thing for 90." I went, "Whoa, whoa, 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 whoa!"
The wheels for 90.
I just asked you how much this was. You said 220, and now you're saying 90. What's the 90?
Now,
what are we doing?
Don't con me.
Yeah.
Sorry, Marty.
Yeah.
That one's for the Gen Xers out there. Yeah, that was a fun one, though. Yeah, we got real hungry. We didn't know if they were going to feed us. We got some grilled cheese.
Yeah, the food was so bad. Shout out to Cisco, you know?
Yeah, definitely some cafeteria grilled cheese.
Oh,
there.
It was straight up cafeteria grilled cheese.
Oh, yeah.
The spring rolls, though, I could have ate at least a baker's dozen.
For sure. Those empanadas were the grossest things I've ever had in my
life. It was sawdust with, like, spices.
I didn't know sawdust empanadas were a thing, but apparently they are.
Yeah, sawdust empanadas.
And we were also in the basement of a hotel. They couldn't even get us, like, the nice...
And the building was shaken.
It was. What was wrong with that?
Oh, and the water bubbler wasn't plugged in. No cooler.
No.
What are we doing?
We're in the basement. The water. What was happening? It was the weirdest convention I've ever been to, Chris.
Yeah.
I got to be honest with you. You know? Wow. I don't know where I'm going with this.
No.
Then there was the tube. Remember the tube?
The tube.
Yeah. They were like, if the baby has gas, just put this tube.
Oh, and it whistles or something?
Yeah. It'll whistle.
Yeah. I mean, the thing is, there was a handful of things that I was like, didn't know that existed, and that could be very helpful, but I'm not for that thing.
There was a bunch of things that looked like they were also very harmful.
Yeah.
You know?
Yeah, a lot of it didn't make sense. A lot of it was like somebody overthinking things that don't really exist.
Yeah. Well, or like, just like at a regular car, like, how can I corner in on this market?
Yeah, exactly. You know? Yeah. But there was some really cool stuff that, like, you could really drop some money, you just have to tell yourself, no, you know,
you'll be all right.
Now, when I say this, I'm not, you know, the guys, if they put alcohol on that thing. Now, I know that wouldn't make sense because obviously our ladies can't drink.
Of course. Yeah.
And I'm not saying they should not drink. Okay.
No, exactly. Yeah.
That's what
we get this. For the men, if the men had beer,
if they gave the men alcohol.
Yes.
Do you know how much stuff we would have bought?
Oh, are you kidding me? Yeah, please.
Because after like a few and I'm feeling good, you know when you're like happy drunk?
Hey!
And they're like, hey, I like this. Yep, we'll take that.
Oh, you deliver, huh?
Yeah,
okay.
Yeah, and then you wake up and you're like, what have I done?
Seriously, like, you're looking like a Palpatine just says, Mace is gone, what have I done?
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
So if there was alcohol there, just for the people that can drink alcohol.
Yeah.
There would be more sales. That's all I'm trying to say.
For sure.
Yeah.
For sure. Yeah. Well, maybe next time, right? So, this is the last episode in the original Brews and Blasters studio. The cave.
This is it, yeah.
The cave is going to be the nursery.
Yeah, now we're going to an actual cave.
Yeah, what... We're going to.
We have to share it with a bear.
Chris's sub basement, and we're gonna. Yeah, we're moving the studio.
Yeah,
going down the road.
I think you're gonna like it.
I'm so excited. Yeah. I really am. You. I don't know if you know that I would be excited, but I'm very excited about it.
No, you look excited. I think you're gonna like the turnout.
I can't wait.
It's a cool little place.
It's a little space of our own. It's the Brews and Blasters Clubhouse.
Yeah,
kinda.
Yeah. It's pretty
nice.
Sweet. Yeah.
It's gonna be nice. I can't wait. So thank you for building that. Thanks to your lovely wife.
Yeah.
For permitting it.
Yeah.
It's gonna be great.
Well, the good thing about the basement that's not finished is it's a little spooky in there, so she doesn't go in there.
Ooh.
So she doesn't care what happens in there.
Ooh.
You know. That's why I had to throw some paint on the walls.
Yeah, seriously.
Looked like a prison.
No, not one of the nice ones either.
It looked like your typical basement that like some old guy was doing like wood shop down there for too long.
Yeah.
And it needed a facelift.
Needed a little bit of a lift. Yeah.
Yeah.
We'll get them black plate posters down there. It's gonna be great.
I wish I still had them.
We're gonna get new ones. We're gonna get all new ones. All right. They're all gonna be like 2018 themed. All right. Let's get a picture. I don't know. What would you put on a 2018 Blacklight poster?
I had a hard time thinking about it.
Yeah. Maybe it's a Blacklight poster of a good Italian sub.
Yeah. Or like a can of baked beans.
That's good too. Yeah. Not 2018 or anything.
I like a nice can of beans, you know?
But a good can of beans. I could do that. Yeah. Blacklight poster or a can of beans.
This is 30. Italian subs and baked beans.
Yeah, see.
Well, good night, guys. This was fun.
Yeah, we'll get to the Star Wars, we promise. Eventually. But yeah, so with the cave going away and becoming the nursery, I mean, the water heater closet has taken over, you know? Yeah, for all you who don't know, my water heater closet is not just my water heater closet. It is also, like, where all of... Everything Star Wars in my life is stored.
Yeah.
All my action figures. I have, like, 8 different shelves in there. My plumber tells me it's okay.
It's well done, yeah.
Yeah, it's well done. It's 100% safe.
It's safe.
Yeah, definitely. And I have, I have action figure display there. I have many, many things in there. All the Black Series, all 3¾. Yeah, it's all in there.
All the stands, everything looks great.
It does. It still needs work, but I've definitely had to condense a lot because I'm losing, you know, any sort of staging area I have in the cave to do stuff.
Yeah.
So it's been a bit of a task to get everything in there.
Oh man. Yeah.
Consolidating.
I know. It's a lot of work. It is a lot of work.
A lot of packing up.
But
I think I'm gonna do, like, from now on, I'm just gonna have one shelf of Black Series and just, like, rotate stuff in and out of there.
Yeah, move them around, keep it fresh.
No, I did. What I did, I bought like art. You know, like, for comics, you get, like, the nice poly bags for comics.
Yes, yeah.
I bought them for action figures.
Yeah, you gave me a package.
I gave you a bunch. Yeah, I bought two sizes. I got sizes for 3¾, and I got sizes for 6-inch. And these things are less. Your figures aren't gonna decay. Like, they're not gonna get spongy.
Or tacky
or anything like that.
Talking,
you know?
About tacky, yeah.
So.
Or yellowed.
Yeah, they're not going to yellow in there. And I put them in a nice. I like to get the Tupperware with the seal on it.
Yeah, that's nice.
Yeah, so no moisture gets in there.
You could throw that in the ocean; it'll be fine.
For real, yeah, for real. It clamps down and everything. I really believe in those. It's a little bit harder to find, a little bit more expensive, but when you're talking about this stuff. I put my comics in those, and I put my action figures in those.
Yeah.
I'm not collecting for these things to get ruined. For real.
Well, exactly.
Yeah. So if they have to go into storage, I'm going to at least, like, make sure they're, like, you know, moisture sealed and, like, air sealed and everything, so they don't decay in these. Because you just do a regular Tupperware, it's, you know, who knows? You're basically just, like, throwing in a drawer.
Yeah, I mean, it is true. I mean, you have to be careful what you buy, and it looks like you did your research, and it's coming out nice.
Hmm. We'll get that pop. We'll get that. But you got to drink it. Now I'm talking about tankless water heaters. Get a little more space in there.
Yeah.
We'll get it done one day.
Yeah, that thing looked crazy. It looked like something that would be on, like, a spaceship or something.
Hey, all you got to tell me is that water heater is bad, and 2 seconds later I'll be getting that tankless. Give me a reason. I wonder what the kid's going to think of having that thing right off her room, too.
She might love it.
She might love it.
She might love it.
We'll see.
Yeah.
Don't touch the water heater. Toys. Yeah, that's, I'm going to have to figure that one out.
Yeah, she might absolutely love it, man.
Yeah, but it's also next to a water heater. Don't want it near the water heater.
Yeah. And,
you're going to have to figure that one out.
The good news is that you have, you know, the tiers.
Yeah.
And you have the figures on... You know, a little display base.
Yeah, you got the pegs, you got the base, you got everything.
Because, like, my biggest fear would be just, like, the domino effect.
Oh, yeah,
but that's not going to happen.
I've had that too many times. You have to get the stands.
You have to, yeah.
Star stands, I love
them. Well, especially with that many figures in a row like that. I mean, literally, that would be like dominoes.
GW acrylic, man, they're the best.
Yeah.
Yeah, definitely, for sure. So, switching gears here. I just want to make a brief thing. You going to see Infinity War?
Hell, dude... I'm happy you brought this up.
Yeah.
Apparently, this is really funny. This is how you know, like, we're getting older.
Apparently.
Right? Me and Alexa are getting older here.
Mm-hmm.
Apparently, we bought tickets a month ago.
Nice.
Right?
For when?
Saturday at 11.
Look at you, 11 a.m.?
Yeah. She sent me a screenshot.
Didn't even think about p.m. on that one.
No, it's a.m., right?
Yeah, a.m. Didn't even think about p.m. I'm like, you're definitely going 11 a.m.
Yeah. If we could have went earlier, I'm sure we would have.
9:30, please. The breakfast sandwich special.
Yeah. Get us in and out. I want to be home.
I want to be home by 10.
But that was the really funny thing because I was telling her, I think it was like, I don't know when we're talking about it, maybe like Sunday or Monday, and I'm like, we might have to get tickets.
Yeah.
And then she sent me a screenshot when I was at work, and she's like, apparently we bought tickets.
Amazing. Amazing.
So we have tickets.
Are you going to Peabody?
Oh yeah, Liberty Tree. Yeah.
Yeah, yeah, definitely. Yeah.
Convenience.
Yeah. I got the Dolby Theater.
I think we have that, but I'm not 100% sure.
I'm going Thursday, 7 p.m.
Whoa.
Yeah, but I'm.
I didn't know you were going to a fan event.
I'm not going to the fan. That's at 6. That's at 6. I can't make it to that. I won't be home. But I was like, I gotta go see this movie, you know. And Thursday at 7 made sense to me. It was the first time I could see it. I'm going alone, so I pick your seat. Yeah, I pick your seat.
Good seat. You had plenty of options.
It's a little bit towards the front, but that Dolby Theater get the recliners. Recline right back. I feel good about it.
Yeah.
I never worried about. I gotta be honest with you here. I always liked the front seat. I always did. Even when I was a kid. When it was a flat, you know, the flat seats before the stadium seating.
The front row.
I hate it.
It's
the
worst.
I always loved it. I love being right there. Boom. Blow me away.
When The Last Jedi came out, when we went to go see it at Jordan's.
Yeah. Well, that's a little rough.
The one that, that's when you couldn't make it, right?
Yeah.
So, we showed up an hour before and that wasn't good enough.
Yeah.
And we were in like the third or fourth row and it was the worst experience ever.
Well, that's the most stadium seating right there.
Yeah.
Because those seats are very steep. So if you're not only in the front, you're at the bottom.
Right, yeah,
you know?
Exactly.
It's not like you're in the front. You're at the bottom of the screen.
Yeah, that's why I was like, I'm very happy I already saw this movie.
That's like a three-story screen. It's
because
a huge screen.
If that was the first screening of that movie, I would have been so mad.
Yeah, for real. Yeah, those seats are actually not good. But this one in the Dolby Theater will be fine. I'm like maybe three rows back.
It's very spacious in there.
Yeah.
And I feel like wherever you sit, it's a good one.
Bigger than butt kickers too.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I see. We figured it out. We figured out the perfect row and the perfect number seat that we really enjoy. It's like E or I forget what it is. I'll let you know.
Nice.
I keep forgetting. Obviously, she does all of that. But yeah, we were like, we saw a movie there. I don't remember what movie. And we're like, this is it. Remember this row and these seats. Like, this is ours.
That's
you know?
Awesome.
And so we've been getting those. But yeah, I mean, wow, look at you, man. I didn't know you were going Thursday. I
literally pulled the trigger today.
I heard the people that are going to the fan event one at 6 p.m., they get slapped around by Thanos.
Really?
Yeah, that's like the free gift.
Wow, that sounds amazing.
Yeah. No, but this movie, I can't wait to see it. There's so much going on. There's so many people in the movie.
Yeah.
I feel like there's going to be shocking moments in this.
Yeah, I've heard that it's very shocking. Don't want to get spoiled. That's also why I want to go as fast as possible, you know?
Wait a second. That's tomorrow, right?
Yeah, it's tomorrow.
That's right. Wow.
Yeah, definitely.
Don't tell me nothing.
Okay.
I'm going to stay off of things because I have a feeling like, something's got to happen.
Yeah.
Something's got to happen in this movie.
Mm-hmm.
You know, and I don't want to be spoiled. I that's one thing that I absolutely hate about social media.
Oh, yeah.
Is there's people out there, just jerks, that will change their handle name to the main spoiler.
Yeah. That is the worst thing ever.
And it reminds me of that scene from Jane, Silent Bob Strike Back when at the end of the movie they fly to everybody that writes hate mail and they beat them up. I wish we could do that.
I love it. Oh man, that is pretty good. That is pretty good. Yeah, so I wanted to get in and see that ASAP.
Who are you who's your guy or girl for like if anywhere? Like who gets you going? Like who do you like here?
I mean, it's almost like two different questions, but I mean, Captain America is like my man.
He looks cool with the beard, with the long hair.
Oh, yeah, definitely.
Know? He looks cool. I like the look. He's not like the clean soldier boy. He's more of like the... He looks like he's been
he's
on
nomad.
Vacation.
He's nomad right now. Yeah. I like that. And I'm also a big fan of... I like my Spider-Man.
Yeah.
Definitely like my Spider-Man.
That kid did a really good job.
He did a great job. I'm excited to see him. So that's a big deal for me. I'm just a big fan of the Marvel movies in general. I love Thor. Yeah. As well, Thor Ragnarok was unbelievable.
That was a really good movie.
Great movie.
Well, I mean, Thor with the Hulk, those two actors, Chris and Mark, together, that was a really good team up.
Oh yeah, definitely. So I can't wait. I can't wait.
I want
to
know how much money it cost to make this movie.
Yeah, for real. It's more than a meatball sub. I'll tell you that much,
oh,
kid.
Oh yeah.
Hey, it's Greg Grunberg, Snap Wexley from Star Wars. I didn't fly an X-Wing, I flew a double XL wing. And you are listening to Brews and Busters.
Blasters.
Oh. And you are listening to Brews and Blasters.
Brilliant. Cheers, Greg. Thanks. Have a good night. See you later.
We'll fix it post.
Oh, yeah, yeah. Definitely.
Yeah, we'll edit that out.
Hey, I was going to say, I like how you didn't fix that.
No, why? It's gold. It's amazing.
Yeah, because when you sent it to me, I was like, oh my God, he said it wrong.
I love when he messes it up.
Yeah.
I love when people, it's even better.
But that was like, you know, stand up of him being like, no, I'm going to do it again for you.
I've never heard Greg Grunberg do another Star Wars podcast. That's all I'm saying. Yeah. Or Eunice do call-outs.
That's true. And hey, remember.
Yeah.
He didn't charge us.
No, he didn't. He just did out of the good of his heart. He's big time right now.
Hey, he not only is he like on top of the world right now, but he's like going to a ton of conventions.
Uh-huh.
When I tell you, we met him at the prime time.
Yeah, like, we were ready.
Guys, when me and Joe met him, there was like, what, a person in front of us?
Before Last Jedi.
Yeah.
He didn't know how big he was about to be.
There was one person in front of us, and then it was me and Joe just talking to this dude.
Yeah. He's just a young man. He's a good guy.
He's a solid guy.
He's a solid guy. Family man.
Family man. Very friendly.
Yeah.
Down to earth.
Respectful. Humble.
He's a guy you could talk to for a while.
Yeah,
and
absolutely.
He makes you feel comfortable. There's nothing weird.
Yeah.
And he goes down as super dude.
Super dude. Absolutely super dude. Absolutely shocked that we wanted his autograph. Or we wanted a call out from him.
Yeah, he was like, you want what?
Really?
You want to record my voice?
You want me to say something? Like, you're like, dude, you're Chewbacca. He's like, yeah, but I think it's the first time, like, maybe people really were like, we love you as Chewbacca, you know?
Yeah, well, I think...
All respect to Mr. Mayhew, because...
Yeah.
Sir Peter Mayhew is, you know...
Yeah,
we knighted him. He's a knight.
Peter's Chewbacca.
Peter's Chewbacca.
But guess what?
New generation. Eunice is too.
Eunice is doing a fantastic job.
Bang up job.
I'm very, very, very happy with his performance.
I'm so happy we have a guy like Eunice as Chewbacca.
But we met him at the time that it was still the scale of people were going, well, what it was Peter or was he Eunice Sotamo? Like, I'm confused. I'm confused. I think we met him at that point. After this movie, after Solo, there's going to be a line for this dude.
This movie's going to make him.
Yeah.
Because from what we've seen from the trailer, a lot of funny stuff.
He's doing a lot more with his Instagram page.
Yeah.
He's getting really in touch with everybody.
I know.
He's, like, I'm telling you, man, watch. Yeah. There's going to be a giant line.
So speaking of getting in touch with people, you know, last episode, we announced a couple of contests, cleaning out the prize closet, remember?
I don't remember. Well, it's been so long.
Well, we did. It has been a while. We did. We cleaned up the prize closet. I want to announce a couple of winners.
Okay.
All right. You want to do this?
What were the prizes?
You don't remember.
Joe, I'm not going to lie to you. I don't remember none of it.
Yeah, well, that vodka was flowing that night.
No, but I remember, like, the night, but I just don't remember your giveaways.
Okay, so we were giving away the Awaken to the Force Star Wars Breakfast and Brunch Cookbook.
Oh, I remember. I remember. Yep, yep.
Yeah, yeah, yeah. So, we're giving it away. Our good man, Richard Chase, wrote in. We said, what's the perfect eating day? Okay? We wanted to tell... That was the thing. Tell us what we'll select it. Richard wrote in, okay? Greetings, Renegades. I thought I'd take a stab at the perfect eating day. My perfect eating day starts out rather simply, then builds to a nighttime feast.
Whoa, okay.
Breakfast. No breakfast is complete without a nice hot cup of coffee and a newspaper. Not bad. Preferably a cup of Kona coffee. I don't know. Then I'm going with a scotch egg. You got me sold there. By the way, they have great scotch eggs at Thwaites Market in Methuen.
I had one of these before. Now, a scotch egg is, it's like breaded almost with sausage.
Sausage.
Yeah,
exactly.
It sounds a little weird, but I'll tell you, it's delightful.
It's delicious.
You can't eat too many of those.
No,
like,
one,
I had a half
one
of
will
one.
Do you.
Yeah, exactly.
Yeah. Yeah, and a bacon, egg, and cheese sandwich on a sriracha bagel. Now we're talking.
Well, wait a second. This is
serious.
What he starts off the day with?
This is the breakfast.
Oh, geez, Rich. Geez.
This is the perfect eating day.
I have a yogurt. You just put me to shame.
Maybe you don't know how to do breakfast, Chris. I thought you knew.
Well, you know, Monday through Friday.
For lunch, he's staying simple. A super beef three-way. And you have to make sure you're getting it from the right place, not Pete's Super Beef.
Did he write that?
No, oh, that's but I'm great. Saying it.
Yeah, don't go to Pete's.
No, Chris got food poisoning. Yeah. We don't even care.
I almost died.
The beef needs to be warm, not hot. It needs to be shaved and cooked rare on an onion roll.
I 100% agree. You have to get shaved.
He knows, if it's not shaved and it's not an onion roll, you don't get a Super Beef three-way. Super Beef is on the onion roll.
It is on the onion roll, unless you go to Kelly's because they don't believe in the onion roll.
Well, they're morons at Kelly's. No one goes to Kelly's
what
anymore.
What are they, a Moroff?
You're a Moroff. Yeah, seriously. If you get the sesame roll, you don't get a Super Beef. You get a Big Beef, baby. You really do. It's a Big Beef. There's Junior Beef, there's Big Beef, and there's Super Beef.
Yeah.
Super Beef got the onion roll.
Remember Giorgio's? They used to put a little piece of bread in the middle.
Oh, kid, I can tell you stories
about
Giorgio's. It was
like picture a Big Mac, but yeah. a roast beef.
I could tell you stories about Giorgio's, make your head spin.
Giorgio's was delicious, man.
Delicious.
Did you? I was going to say, you're with me on that, right?
Oh, my gosh.
Because, like, when me and my mother went and when we got roast beefs, we went to Giorgio's.
I got to tell you, if that place opened up at 10 p.m., it wouldn't even have mattered.
Hey, yeah. That guy... Yeah. I don't know if the owner was, you know, Giorgio.
Yeah.
He's working at Beachmont Roast Beef.
Oh.
Yep, that's how you know. When I walked in there, I wasn't getting a roast beef at first.
Real talk.
When I went in there and saw him, beef time.
Really?
Yep. Guess what? Delicious.
Okay, now, a couple of questions. Now, there was a couple other people who worked there. All right? The guy with the slick back hair, is he there? Is he at Beachmont?
I didn't see him.
Okay, he was a friend. He was good. They got breakfast at Beachmont Roast Beef.
I saw that. They have a banner.
I've been dying to know.
I got a banner guy. I should like hook him up with him.
Yeah, you should. You do have a banner guy. But I want to know about the breakfast over there because it looks good. Beachmont Roast Beef. Come on, that's an institution.
Hey, the beef is good. It is. You know, it's next to a train station.
Yeah.
You know, you walk in, you're like, what am I doing to my body?
Yeah.
And then you take a bite of the beef, and you're like, okay. Yeah.
Hey, I had Luigi's across the street for pizza the other day.
Hey.
Still got it.
The girl with the blonde hair working there?
No, she was...
She wasn't there?
It was an older lady.
Oh.
Yeah.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah, they yell through the window, two slices.
Yeah, it's still good. It's still good.
We like our trashy places, you know?
These are institutions.
Yeah, I mean, it's glad to see... I'm glad to see that they're still around.
If they were gone, I would be very sad.
Yeah.
You know?
Luigi's been around for a while now.
Luigi's is the very first place I remember getting food outside my house.
Yeah, I mean, as far as...
I remember when I was like a little child.
Yeah, we always got, yeah.
Yeah, Luigi's.
Pizza's good there. Very greasy, but I like the grease. You know, you gotta get that greasy pizza, you know?
Yeah, I've had greasy, don't worry.
The thing is, when we moved to Peabody, right?
Yeah.
Now we have to get introduced to all the local restaurants.
Totally different.
And you mind fight with everything. Like, no, it's not like back home. It's not like back home. And then you need to tell yourself, this is home now. But I'll tell you, Plum Tomatoes has the best pizza around.
Oh, I've heard of Plum Tomatoes.
Yeah. Dude, it's the best pizza. And I'm telling you, like, every time I have pizza somewhere else, I'm like, it's not like Plum Tomatoes. It's not.
Wow.
It's that good, man.
All right, man. Well, I guess we're going.
Brick oven.
All right, we're going.
They get the thin crust. They get a toasty on the bottom.
That's awesome.
They get voted best pizza all the time. I think they just give it to them now because, like, nobody else goes up against them.
No one even tries.
Yeah, exactly. Yeah.
All right, so we're only halfway through Rich's email here. I may or may not supplement my beef with a pizza roll. It's totally valid.
Oh, nice. Okay.
Supper. I'm picturing a grand Italian
feast. Did he write supper?
Yes.
I like you, Rich.
This is why he's
winning. You're a good guy.
This is why he's winning the contest. I'm starting off with a few steak tips, cooked medium rare in a sweet marinade garnished with vinegar peppers. He knows how to do it right. Just a few because I'm only wetting the palate. Then we roll up the main course. I'm going with either a manicotti or a stuffed shell. All right. As long as the regatta is light and fluffy, you're golden. I'm going to smother them in sauce or gravy if you're a gravy person with meatballs, Italian sausage, and a side of garlic bread.
I'll tell you, RC knows how to eat.
Yeah, he really does. RC. I like that, RC.
RC, yeah.
RC, that's your nickname now. If you've left room for the dessert, I got some lobster tails. Now we're talking.
Oh, the pastry.
Yeah.
Yeah.
I love those. I absolutely love a good lobster tail. snowball cookies, the ones flavored with anise extract, not lemon, and lemon meringue pie. Top it all off with a bourbon Manhattan, and you've got one heck of an eating day. Good journey, your pal Rich, official electrician at RetroZap, along with Joe's brother.
Well, he definitely deserves to win that, because that is that took a lot of effort. Number one, write all that.
Yes,
and when I tell you, like, he nailed it.
He nailed it.
I don't know if I could consume all of that in one day.
Yeah,
but that's impressive. Very impressive.
I know.
So congratulations, RC. You have a cookbook coming.
Well, he wins the cookbook. I mean, we're talking about food here.
Yeah.
You know?
It's the perfect giveaway for that email.
Yeah, definitely. Definitely. All right. We had another one, though. We had two contests last time. We had two.
Was the second one for, like cards or
the
something?
The top Trump's card set.
See, I remember. It's coming back to me.
Yeah. All right. Now, this is good.
I almost lost me marbles.
This was a tough one. We had a lot of good entries on this. So
really,
if you wrote in,
people were really cranked about this.
Yeah,
one.
They got really cranked. If you didn't win, it's not that we didn't like it. We loved all of them, because you were all right there. You know, a lot of people going with, like, you know, the Gamorrean guards, right?
Yeah,
they were going with Gamorrean guards. A lot of, you know, they all had it there. Gotta give it to Andrew Djarczar, all right? Because he has the most creative ones, okay? He has the most creative ones. So, he's a longtime fan of the weird guys.
We are the weird guys.
Yeah, and a card collected since 77 when they were the only ways to relive the film. His picks are, number 5, Moloch. Now, I really like this Moloch character from Solo.
Oh, yeah. Yeah,
weird ant face guy.
It's kind of like the Sacco Plank guy.
Yeah, but I think this guy's actually, like, going to do something. He's, like, with stormtroopers in a card I saw.
I think he's, like, is he, like, part of the crew?
I think he's a creepo. I don't know what he's doing.
He's a creepo?
He's a creepo. I don't know. Yeah. Enfys Nest. Enfys, right? Not Enfys.
I think it's Enfys. People are saying Enfys.
Yeah.
Kasdan did say Enfys.
All right.
We don't know. We don't know if it's a Han, Han, tomato, yeah. Tomato.
Hey, did he know? Lando called him Han in this movie?
He did, yeah.
He did, yeah.
No, I'm a huge fan of Enfys Nest.
Yeah. Yeah.
Okay, I'm really cranked.
Don't know if it's a girl or a boy. We don't know yet. We don't know.
We have an idea.
There's conflicting reports.
Yeah.
You know? A lot of product action calling the character a female. Star Wars Insider calling it a male. I don't know.
Did they really?
They did. Yeah.
Ooh.
Yeah. So
now it got interesting.
Now we got a couple of horses in the race, right? We don't know what's what.
Now, I don't know if I was thinking too much into it, but I have the 3.75 action figure.
Yeah, we're going to get into that and Needham got him.
Yeah. I mean, I was just comparing heights, and she... Enfys,
yeah,
seems kind of short.
Okay.
So I don't know if I'm just looking too much into something.
All right.
But either way, guy, girl, alien, creature, I don't care.
Yeah.
I love it. I love the design of the character.
Yeah.
I'm really excited to see him or her in action.
We're ripping this thing open and Needham got him a little bit. Trust me.
I'm into it. I'm digging it. Let's go.
Number 3. Fully articulated, live-action style Star Wars Rebels Gara Zebrelius.
Ooh.
In a vest.
Yeah, we need that. Yeah, in a vest. That was important that he said that.
This is why Andrew's winning. Because it's, like, I love everyone who submitted. We got Oppos in there, and we want the Oppo.
Yeah.
You know?
True that.
Hashtag source of snake.
Yeah.
Get out there after it. Gotta get out there.
Hashtag Oppo Chrysosis.
No, they gave away your baby's name.
Yeah. Oh, sorry, guys.
Oh, man.
No, it was funny because the first time we saw Zeb with the vest, right? Was that season 3? I'm not sure.
Season 3 or 4, I don't know.
People were talking about all kinds of crazy things, right? First
Hot
thing we
callus,
said. Yeah,
you
the
know.
First thing we said, we're like, Zeb has cut sleeves.
Yeah, we like that. Frayed sleeves, let's do it. Number 2. Therm Scissor Punch 2-pack with angel hair pasta and a Siamese prawns accessories.
All right. I think he's cheating because he's like winning like our hearts over with all of this.
He listens to the show. Yeah. He knows.
I was going to say, how does he know this about us?
Yeah,
I forget that we record it and put it out to the public.
This is released to the world.
Oh, it's true. I thought we were just hanging out.
We are, but people around the world get to listen too. It's amazing. It's amazing. You want to get a little recap on some of the places people listen to?
Yeah.
All right. We're just gonna stop in the middle of
Yeah, but that's so.
Before we'll do some anticipation for number one. You know,
those were all Black Series figures that he wanted to get made.
Yeah.
Yeah, he won.
Yeah, we haven't even revealed number one yet. You know.
So you started off with two?
I started with 5-5-4-3.
Oh, that's what we're doing.
Yeah.
5-5-5.
Yeah, 5-5-5. Yeah, I gotta give a big shout out to the three people in India who've been listening.
Oh, sweet, we made it over there.
Yeah. The one person in Cambodia. Yep, the one person in Indonesia. You know, we got a big following in Australia.
That's huge because collecting's really huge over there.
Yeah, seriously. And New Zealand, big following New Zealand
too. Nice, New Zealand, that's the Fets. They're from New Zealand.
Yeah, definitely. Yeah, gotta love it. The one person in China who's
just one?
Yeah, we got one person in China listening.
It's highly populated too.
Yeah, billions of people.
Maybe that one person could tell a few more people. So if you're listening, that'd be cool.
Yeah, definitely. The 13 people in Japan listen, we love you.
Wow, that's a lot, yeah.
Yeah, definitely. The three people in Russia, awesome. You know? Wow, we're big in Italy.
Really?
Yeah, that makes me feel because we're Italian.
Well, the thing too is we talk about a lot of food.
It's true. We got people. We got one person listening in Morocco, one person in Portugal. You know, we got people in Norway and Sweden. Yes, one person in Denmark. The UK. UK is one of our top places.
How many?
We got top.
Just
men.
Wink if it's good.
Yeah, wow, I'm winking.
He's winking.
I'm winking, all right. It's good.
Winky, winky.
Oh, man, big shout out to Canada. Oh, South America, you kidding me? Ecuador, Colombia, Brazil,
anybody
Argentina.
Like Fiji?
Fiji. I don't think we got Fiji out here.
I don't think they have computers, man.
You know, they're probably better off for it, please.
They have, like, coconuts and, like, string and stuff, right?
Yeah, we give them Brews and Blasters. Next thing you know, the thing is just, like, on, like the whole island's on fire and like, sinking into the sea. Like, what happened? It was perfect here.
I mean, if you're listening, we would love to come over and record.
Yeah, we'll do
one
live
of those,
show.
Those tiki huts.
Yeah.
And drink out of, like, coconut drinks. We're down for that.
Down for it. Yeah, definitely. Definitely. We won't.
We can get there in a kayak, right?
Yeah, we can kayak face over there.
14 years later, we made it.
Big beards. Oh, man. Okay, so moving on. The number one figure to be made in 2018, all right? He got creative with this one, and I think he's going to like it. Snoke's mute alien navigator with navigation station.
Oh, cool. Yeah, that like blue-eyed, tall...
Purple tall, blue, weird creepo.
Black
weird
cape.
Guy. Where did they go?
Black and blue face.
Black and blue face. Yeah.
Skinny, black robe, black and blue, blue eye guy.
Yeah. Yeah, him.
Yeah, beat that.
He actually said that. He wrapped up the email, beat that.
Oh, he did?
Yeah.
Yeah, well, that was a good one.
Sack-a-lackers. Yeah.
Sack-a-lackers.
Yeah.
And that's it. That's how you win stuff around here.
That's it. So you won. You're the big winner. Top Trumps. Top Trumps card set. That was fantastic. Other people who entered, you know, Phil, a lot of people.
Huge shout out to you guys.
Yeah, definitely. Like, we're talking Gamorrean Guards. We're talking Mimba. You know, we're talking, Tobias. You know, Snoke. These are all great, great submissions. Absolutely. You know? Oppo Rancis' Black Series, you know, that would have been fantastic.
I would drop a hundo right now on him.
I'd drop two hundo. For sure. Absolutely.
We got to get this made.
Yeah. Source the snake. Hashtag source the snake.
You know what we should just do?
At Hasbro News on Twitter. Source the snake. Everyone get out there and get after it.
You know what we have to do? We got to do a mock-up, right?
Oh. Just
hear me out. A mock-up, right?
Yeah.
HasCon is skipping this year.
It's true.
They're back 2019.
Yeah.
We're going to pitch it to them.
It's true. We should pitch it to them before that so they have it ready for HasCon. Big reveal.
But the good thing is that they can't escape us at HasCon because they're there in person.
That's true, too. That's true.
We're going to show up with blueprints, a folder. Dude, we should wear suits. We should go in there.
Three-piece suits.
Yeah, we should go in there with suits.
You know, I want to look like one of the barons on like Into the Badlands. You know the other show?
Yeah, I don't watch that.
A bunch of weird guys. Trust me, a lot of swords, weird guys. check that show. It's wacky. It's a wacky show.
And the thing is, like, I could wear the prototype. You're like, look, forearms, no pants. We're saving money.
Fully articulated. Yeah. There we are. You're just a snake.
Beehive haircut. Let's go.
Let's go.
Real hair beard.
Been growing it for 3 years. Yeah. So, all right. I wanted to do one more. The prize closet isn't cleared out yet.
Now, this is, I don't remember the third one.
Well, this is a new contest.
Oh, it's a new one.
Yeah. Kylo Ren Unmasked. Remember that figure? I have a black series unopened. Right here, right in the prize closet. Kylo Ren Unmasked, black series, 6-inch.
The newer one?
Yeah.
Oh,
yeah,
that's a good one.
I think it was from 2016.
Yeah.
Yeah, I got that.
Were we together on like a Force Friday or something like that? Oh,
yeah.
Okay. I know what you're talking about. This is a nice figure. Here
it's
we go,
a nice
guys.
Figure.
You might
Black
want to
series.
Listen to this one.
Yeah, yeah. This is called the True Believer Contest to win Kylo Ren Unmasked. We're talking, it's True Believer because you have to tweet this, okay?
Okay.
If you're a True Believer and you want to win this Kylo Ren Unmasked Black Series from Brews and Blasters, tweet this exactly. Has to be exact. No additions, no omissions. At Brews and Blaster, our Twitter account, at Brews and Blaster is my favorite hashtag Star Wars, no space, hashtag Star Wars podcast, period.
That's easy.
At Brews and Blaster is my favorite hashtag Star Wars podcast. And not Canadian spelling of favorite, American spelling so we can look it up and search. All right. At Brews and Blaster is my favorite hashtag Star Wars podcast, period.
And we promise we won't ask you for anything else.
If you write that, True Believer, you will win an absolutely free Kylo Ren Unmasked Black Series action figure.
Big shot gangster putting together crew. You in?
I waited a long time for a shot like this.
What are you doing with Harry and the boy?
We need a ship.
The Millennium Falcon.
Every ship isn't for everyone. She needs a particular type of pilot.
You done flirting?
These people are not your friends.
There's a lesson to be learned here.
I got a really good feeling about this.
Oh, yeah.
I'm so excited for this movie. Now, I know I'm staying the obvious here.
Yeah.
But I'm pumped.
We're less than a month out from a brand new Star Wars movie. It's only been a couple of months since the last one.
Yeah. Yeah. It's Overload.
Whoa!
Whoa!
Overload.
It's excellent. I love that we've always talked about how much we love aliens and weird droids.
We're in that world.
We're in that world. We're not coming out of it now.
No,
we're in it. We're in it.
Solo is all about the weird guys.
Yeah.
The background characters getting in there.
As it should, right?
Yeah, really. Like, they're doing it right.
They are.
They're doing this right.
Yeah.
I love it. I love Lando and Han and like just perfect. And he throws him the DL-44.
He does.
Oh, so cool. Everything is cool.
It looks like Beckett gives him that gun.
Yeah, probably, right?
Because I think they're sitting around like a campfire and he like throws it to him or something.
I like that L-337 too.
I do too. Yeah, she's cool.
She's cool. You done flirting?
Hey, you know what else is pretty wild is when we saw Rio Durant, the four-armed monkey dude.
Uh-huh.
Now, I thought like, all right, he's going to be first off, he's super cool.
I thought he was more like a Bistan character.
Exactly.
You know?
I thought he was going to be like, all right, we're going to see this guy shortly.
Yeah.
And maybe that might be it.
Wrong!
But now he has his own, like, single poster character.
Yeah. The director of Iron Man is voicing him.
Yeah, John Favreau. Have you heard of him?
John Favreau.
Yeah.
You ever see Rudy?
Yeah. He has a heart of gold.
Yeah. Swingers.
Yeah. Pre-Vizsla.
Yeah. The Jungle Book. Yeah.
Big time stuff. The upcoming Lion King.
Swingers.
Yeah. So Rudy's made. Rudy. Yeah.
Yep.
But we talked about Love and Sex. That was a great movie.
Great movie, too. Yeah,
I really like that.
Yeah.
We're talking Couples Retreat.
Rudy.
We're talking Home for the Holiday.
We're talking Rudy.
Is that what that movie's called with Vince Vaughn?
Yeah, that one, too.
Something like that.
Yeah.
But he's well known.
He is.
And
he's Rio Durant.
We almost forgot this. He's going to be writing and directing the first ever Star Wars live action series.
Oh, that. How could I forget?
Yeah, we always forgot about that one.
Whoa.
Unbelievable. But yeah, it seems like if they're giving him a poster.
Yeah.
I think he's going to be more in the movie than I expected.
Oh, he's part of the crew.
And I want him to be.
Oh, yeah, me too. Me too.
So I'm really excited about that. The droid, L3.
L337.
Yeah, 37, right?
Yeah.
She's really cool. I absolutely love all these droids having a strong personality.
Here are the posters right here. We got Beckett. Woody Harrelson is Beckett right there. And I love that the background is all the...
I'm putting together a crew.
Yeah, the background is the Han Solo cockpit.
Big shot gangster.
There's the one thing I don't like about these posters. And I have a big, big issue with this. Yunus Utamo is not as Chewbacca. They don't list Yunus Utamo on this. Everyone else is...
Hey.
Yeah. Woody Harrelson as Beckett.
You're right.
Yeah.
What's up with that?
What up with that? What up with that? Yeah, seriously, Yunus belongs on here side by side with everyone else.
Well, he is 100% Chewbacca in this movie.
He has comedic bits. He is an actor. He's acting.
Yeah.
As much as anyone else.
They gave him lines.
They actually gave him lines.
So, you know, like Alden could, you know, go back and forth with him.
Yeah, exactly.
So it's not just a guy in a suit. He's acting.
He's acting. He's not just like a guy. It's not just like
he's doing it.
Yeah, seriously. He's an actor. He belongs up there or with everyone else. He's a main person in the film. Peter Mayhew got billing as Chewbacca.
He did.
Yeah. He belongs up there with everyone else.
And she did too.
Phoebe Waller-Bridge as L337 got up there. Yunus belongs up there too.
That's weird, man.
Yeah, it is weird. I gotta be honest. You know? Donald Glover as Lando. Awesome. Emilia Clarke as Kira. Yes. Alden Ehrenreich as Han.
Dude, he looks great in that picture.
He looks
right?
great. Now we're talking Tandy Newton as Val.
Hey, you know what's great? Alexa pointed out, she was like, that's the chick from Westworld.
Yes, it is.
And I was like, good pickup.
She is unbelievable in Westworld. I love that show.
Alexa's huge into that. I watched the first episode.
I haven't seen it yet. Don't tell me nothing.
No, well, I mean, coming from a guy that watched scattered episodes from season one, watching season two, I didn't quite get what was going on. So I actually couldn't even spoil it for you.
When I lost my voice back in December 2016, I watched all of them. Yeah, it was unbelievable. I was homesick on the couch. And I just watched
just
all
blasted
of them.
Through them.
Yeah,
I'll tell you what I blasted through. Me and her, we blasted through the new Lost in Space.
Oh my god, I watched the first two episodes. Unbelievable.
You hooked?
Yeah,
dude,
I'm hooked.
It's good. Like
so good. They drop you right in first episode.
The one downfall.
The creepy doctor's not in it.
No. The one downfall of Netflix is that they give you this beautiful season and say we'll see you next year.
Yeah, that is true.
And you know, my mom, she has good willpower. Because,
I mean, Dr. Smith's in it, but it's. She's not as creepy as the original one.
They switched that around.
I mean, it's fine. You know, the actress is unbelievable, but you can't mimic the creepiness of the original Doctor.
The robot's the best, man.
The robot is the best, for sure.
Like I was saying, my mom has strong willpower because when I told her about Stranger Things,
yeah,
She watches like one or two episodes and lets a month pass and watches it again.
I don't know how you can do those Stranger Things.
No, because she was like, I don't want to blast through it. And then like, I'm going to forget by the time like the next season comes out. I'm like, you have a great point, but you also have like huge willpower because we're like, keep binge watching. Like I'm talking like 2 days, it's done.
Dude, I was up till 4 a.m. Yeah. I was up till 4 a.m. one night just watching Stranger Things. Unbelievable.
Oh, Stranger Things. We blasted through season two, I think a day and a half.
Yeah, same here. Same here. So Star Wars, we got the Solo movie coming out. Wow, we were out there.
Yeah, well, we saw a lady from Westworld. Yeah.
Now, Tandy, I can't wait for Val. She's been talking, doing a lot of interviews. Val seems like a really cool character.
Yeah, I'm excited. I'm pumped. I hope all of these characters get action figures.
We need a Val action figure, 100%. We definitely do.
Yeah, we need this stuff.
Yeah, definitely.
But yeah, this movie, let me tell you, it's going to be something special.
Let me tell you something about this movie, all right? It's only the first of three. Have you heard about this?
No.
Alden, let's slip a little bit of info.
Get out of here, dude. Solo's getting a trilogy?
He slipped. He slipped, Chris. He wasn't supposed to say nothing. Okay?
He was probably so excited.
Yeah, he wasn't supposed to say nothing. But according to Esquire, and I'm getting this from Fantatrax. According to Esquire, it appears the young Han Solo, Alden Ehrenreich, will be coming back as Han Solo sometime in the future, confirming that Han survives the events of the first film. Well,
are you kidding me?
It's a joke. It's a joke. Spoiler alert. As he signed up for three movies. Yeah. All right. So this is from the Esquire interview. He know what he's getting into. It's a deeper commitment than just one movie. Even Ford couldn't quit after just one. I ask Ehrenreich how many he signed up for. Three, he says. Then flinches, understanding that he may have just created a disturbance in the Force. I don't know if that's officially public, but yeah.
That's so funny. Well, I mean, the thing is, like, he's been in a lot of other movies, but nothing to this magnitude.
Yeah.
So, like, I mean, I understand, like, Lucasfilm and Disney are like, listen, you guys can't. They're gonna try to trick you. They're good out there. They're good.
It's like when you hit someone with a question real fast and they just answer you like.
That's an honest mistake.
Yeah, it's like Chris, favorite eggs, go, and you're like, oh, yellow.
I'm like,
I think you just say you're like, they were like, yeah, how many movies? Three. Oh,
yeah, but you know how much press he's doing right now?
Yeah,
he probably has no sleep.
I know.
Like,
yeah.
If I would, honest to God, if I was Disney Lucasfilm, like, I'd be like, hey, don't let it happen again. Like, I get it. Like, we're sending you all over the world to promote this movie, which we don't really need to promote because people are so amped about it.
Cranked.
Yeah. I mean, they're getting cranked.
They're getting really cranked.
I'm cranked, man. I'm getting cranked. I'm getting like like little kid cranked. You know what I mean? Like, I'm getting like oh my God, we're like 30 days away. Yeah.
All right, last story for tonight. You ever hear of composer John Powell?
It does sound familiar, but that's it. That's where it ends with me.
You'll know him after this because he's the one composing the score.
Oh, okay.
For Solo: A Star Wars Story.
So they're just like grabbing different people.
Yeah, I mean, you know, they have to grab people for these quote unquote anthology films.
Yeah.
And I mean, they got John Powell. He's in How to Train Your Dragon.
Oh, good. I love that movie.
The Bourne Identity, great soundtrack on that, too. Rio, great soundtrack. Shrek, Chicken Run, X-Men The Last Stand are some of his credits.
Okay, so all Disney movies, basically.
I think a lot of DreamWorks in there, too.
Yeah.
You know, Shrek, Rio, How to Train Your Dragon. You know, the guy got chops. He's a workman. He got some stuff.
Well, I mean, he's not green.
Yeah, a little more rockin' too, I gotta be honest with you. I mean, Shrek was a pretty rockin' soundtrack.
Well, I mean, everything that we've heard so far on this, the Solo trailer.
Feels very rock and roll.
It feels rock and roll. It feels like, let's go to a dive bar.
Gritty.
Yeah.
Yeah, a little grittier. I like that.
Yeah, me too.
Yeah, definitely. A little punk rock action. You know, I really dig it. So I think he's gonna be a good pick. I'm really excited to hear what he puts together for this. I think it's going to be a dramatic departure from what we've ever heard from a Star Wars soundtrack.
Yeah, it's going to be different. I mean, yeah. it's a different feel for a movie, so...
Yeah, I mean, Rogue One, for all of its differences from the original trilogy and the prequels and the sequel trilogy, for all its differences, its soundtrack, you know, it can live alongside the John Williams ones. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like, it was all right there. And that's good. It's fine. Totally. It should live there because, you know, the film lives right there. But I'm okay with this one being a radical departure. Let's get weird with this one. Get crazy.
Absolutely. Yeah. I agree with that.
Don't pull the punches. So I'm excited. The soundtrack's available for pre-order. I'm gonna pick it up day of. I know it'll be on Spotify.
They don't have like all the names of the songs, right?
No, nothing like that. No Qui-Gon's noble end on this one, kid.
Yeah.
Yeah, where does the time go?
Where does the time go?
Hey guys, thank you so much for listening to Brews and Blasters yet again. You know where to find us: Fantatrax, Jedi News, Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Stitcher, SoundCloud, iHeartRadio, TuneIn, YouTube, the Star Wars Podcast app, and all other places podcasts can be found. If you're a new listener, we hope you subscribe. And if you can hear our voices right now, we want to hear from you. Talk Star Wars at us. Brews and Blasters at RetroZap.com. Voicemail 978-219-6688. And don't just confine yourself to Star Wars. You want to talk about anything else? Let us know. You want to talk about action figures? What are you finding out there? What are you buying?
Let's do it.
Yeah, what are you talking about there? Want to talk podcasts and talk about anything you want with us. We don't care. You know? Share your thoughts. We want to hear from you. Next week, we're going to do a lot of email.
Oh, yeah.
Catching up. We got oppos. We got a lot of things to do.
We like ye.
It's got to be May the 4th.
Yes, that's true. Very, that's very true. Very true there, Joe.
Yes, cheese. Yes. So, get at us. We are part of the RetroZap Podcast Network. Find it on RetroZap.com or hear every RetroZap show, 21 and counting, in one place with the network feed that's available on all podcast apps. Our official website, brewsandblasters.ninja. Go there for show notes, pictures, subscription info, and more. And if you want to support the show, just leave us an iTunes review. No Patreons. Just an iTunes review. It helps us find the helps more people find the podcast, and you win an Oppo Award. And while you're at it, we want you to tell a friend about Brews and Blasters. Hey, you in China, tell a friend about Brews and Blasters this week. Sharon is caring. Make sure they subscribe. Like us on Facebook. Follow us on Twitter and Instagram. We got things in store. Trust me. While you're at it, get your own Brews and Blasters t-shirt. Go to RetroZap.com. Click the t-shirts in the main menu. You want to get them. Get the Bomar Monk.
That's the best one.
Yeah, get it. Get us having dinner. Get anything you want.
Don't play around. Just get that one.
CollectorsHut.com. TheCollectorsHut.com. Go there. Watch Chris.
Hello.
Go there. Watch Chris. He reviews action figures. That's it. It's amazing. All right, guys. We're out of here. Godspeed, Rebels. Suck a lot and tell it to Kanji Club. I'm afraid the party's canceled, but the summer's never showing. But I know what was penciled, so I was far but it knows. Before it's getting ready, maybe get too much. But I don't want to suffer the rookie's wicked clutch.